glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. This is the kind of match ball both of them used to this huge stage and both of them used to performing at their best when the stakes are the highest. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Washington County in the northwest corner of Arkansas. Razorback Stadium is the site for today's football contest. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Hefner has the ball set how he wants it, and we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks. He'll return it from the one, and he's taken down at the 30. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Gains his way to the 40-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
Tackled outside after a nice pickup. Down around the 43-yard line.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, you're probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
It's third down and 7 yards to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. He's taken down at the 46.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
He's taken down at the 44.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it 7-8.
Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete.
Yeah, anytime a quarterback makes a throw like this, the best thing a wide receiver can do is come over to the quarterback and pat him on the back and tell him to shake it off and let's make the next play a better play. The worst thing you can do is put your arms up in the air as if you're blaming the quarterback. Come over, tell him it's all right, and you move on.
He gets hit out of bounds at the 37. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Now he pitches it. He's tackled at the 21.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
Everybody bunched to the 18-yard line. And this is the 11th play of the current drive.
Let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike 53.
Here we go.
Green 9. Throws complete. He stopped immediately.
He brings him down.
fourth down. This one should be makeable. Arkansas take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. From his own goal line. Gets out to about the 21. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. And he's tackled at the 18. From their own 18-yard line, second down. Tackle at the 28. The option gets him 10 and fullback make it look easy.
That makes it third and three.
Two tights.
Two down.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Smart call here to trust your line and the ball carrier to gain the yards they had to for the first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 32. Runs outside for a nice gain. He keeps it on the option and picks up maybe four.
That makes it 7-6.
They'll bring him down at about the 37. And so it's another third down upcoming here. Fires out to his receiver, and down he goes around the 45-yard line. The Seminoles are looking for some new players to step up this season, Herbie. And, you know, every team needs a new star to be born year in and year out because you lose a fifth of your roster to graduation every year. Their own 45-yard line. First down. And they make the stop at the 10-yard line. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Run there. They get about four on that keeper.
That brings them second and five.
Second down and five. Ball on the six. Florida State. And he tacks on the extra point. A nice 9-play, 80-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
It's fielded at the two. And he just got stood up right there. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Makes it out to about the 39. An exciting first quarter comes to an end. 7-3, Seminole. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Good tackle there in space. They go to the left for a nice gain. He's at the 20. He is drilled at the 17-yard line. Him down in the backfield.
That was a loss of 1 yard.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback.
He gets rid of this one. Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They'll line it up for the field goal. It's up, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. Kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Florida State, up a point. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good. That brings him second and five.
It's second and five here. Ball on their own 30. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great player recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
Razorback quarterback went down with that injury that you saw earlier. We don't want to speculate, but he's in the locker room and it doesn't look good. And he's hit immediately. Fires it out. They pick up a few yards there on the pass.
And I'll tell you what, that fake handoff froze the secondary just enough to allow for the receiver to come up with a nice gain that time. Good call.
First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. He's at midfield. Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
First down.
He fights forward to about the 40. From the 40-yard line, it's second down.
Mike 40.
Gets gets to about the 37-yard line. Florida State is up one. Makes the grab past the marker. Brought down at the 31-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series.
You must be getting tired of seeing me. You can choose the mic. Watch Mike.
Here's the throw to the fullback. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Now he tries to buy some time. The ball pops free. And he's taken down at the 17. The Seminoles are going to call their second timeout. And this is the 10th play of the drive. The 10. He gets out to about the 8.
That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. That's a great tackle at the 5-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. He fired it out to his wide receiver, who made the grab and got the score.
When this guy's got time to throw, he makes the defense pay.
He hits the PAT. A 12-play, 70-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 23.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. The only problem is, they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Slings it to his fullback. He's taken down around the 34-yard line. A great first half comes to a close. The Seminoles in front by 8.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw, both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they tried to come up with. So, to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickery?
A little trickery never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that, if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run some reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. you know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surrounding studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler in Kirk Herb Street.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He'll return it from the one. Across the 30. And he's taken down at the 38. Kickoff return 38 yards. The offense will take the field, and they've been moving the ball very well on their last couple of drives. Florida State holds an 8-point advantage. Makes it out to about the 49.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From their own 49-yard line, it's first down. He laterals. And he's level at the 48.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Roger, Roger. Mike 40, Mike 40. Let's get off the field, man. Let's get off the field. 15.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
It's a good surge by the defense. They really disrupted the timing on that play and gave him no chance to get the first.
Return man. He really got a hold of that one. Touchdown. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Runs right for a nice gain. The 40. He's at midfield. Inside the 30. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line. The 26.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
From the 26-yard line, second down. Tackle made at the 12. Kirk will get a player down, obviously, in some pain. And he's tackled at the 15. The defensive end was the victor on that play as he bolted in to tackle him for a loss.
And he knew that because the interior linemen held their ground, leaving the runner with no options.
From the 15-yard line, second down.
Reset, tight right. Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, Blue. 53.
Blue Ready? 88. Blue 88. Hut, hut. Hut.
They bring him down in the backfield.
Man, did he play that perfectly or what? As a linebacker, you have to be able to read the offense and make a quick diagnosis, which is exactly what he did on that play.
From the 18-yard line, third down.
Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Ready.
quick tipped.
Quick thinking there. You know, they're liable to put the ball in the air on third, so it's a smart play to keep your hands ready.
Kicks away, and he got it. Arkansas is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 21-yard line. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here. The Razorbacks lose one of their key players to that injury earlier. Still in the locker room, we don't know the severity, but unlikely that he'll play any more football this afternoon. Makes it out to about the 29.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. To pitch it, and now the ball is loose. It's recovered. Third and five. Ball on their own 26. Scrambling around, and now the ball is loose. Looks like a defensive lineman might have it, and he does.
I'll tell you, when a guy as big as this lineman gets his paws on a loose ball, you can pretty much about it. You're not getting the ball back from him.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. They'll drop him for a loss. The lineman had a big push there to get in the backfield and bring him down.
And once he gets moving, there's no stopping him. This guy is so big and strong that he's almost impossible to block with one guy.
So it's second and 12. Ball on the 23-yard line. Great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. 14-9, Seminole. Welcome back to the action. Fourth quarter. This one will decide it. Tight ball game through three.
Defense is. Great play by the linebacker to come up with the ball after the fumble.
Well, here we are early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight ball game, and every possession is going to count from here on out. Nice run to the outside.
Second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He has some room.
Man, it's always a plus if you're able to pick up the first down with the running game.
First down.
Mike 40.
Ready?
tackle at the 38-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 38-yard line. There he goes. He's knocked out of bounds at the 47.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Bring him down around the 46-yard line. Wilkerson only gets about a yard there on the option keeper. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Great stop there, and that's going to bring up fourth down.
Before you start to blame the offensive line, really give this defense some credit. They just did a great job.
Defense stacked in tight here. He's at the 30, and down he goes at the 23-yard line. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. And they make the stop at the 9.
The option's one of the more difficult plays to defend. The defense went after the quarterback, which left the running back with plenty of room.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They'll get him for a loss. This is the 11th play of the current drive. Touchdown, Seminole. Thank you.
Play clock's at zero. They took too much time.
Offense.
Thank you.
the PAT. An 11-play, 78-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
The score now, 21-9. Hefner gets set to kick this one away. He'll return it from the 4-yard line, and he's taken down at the 29. A fumble really hurt this team's last drive, so let's see if they can make up for that blunder on this drive.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more, so a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
The ball is loose, and the offense picks it up, and he's tackled at the 24-yard line. Just over a fourth quarter. Spikes the ball. From their own 24-yard line, it's third down. Wants to go long and does. He's hit and taken down.
This is a great pitch and catch combination, and they hook up here for a big-time game.
The spike will stop the clock. It's second and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line.
87's getting the ball. Come on.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. Excellent pressure on that play.
Intended receiver.
Oh, boy. They take a shot here at the end zone, and he just let that one get away from him.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Deep pass to the end zone. Defense stiffens on fourth down, and the ball will change hands.
That's a big-time stop here by the defense. I know we're only in week one, but this defense looks like they're in midseason form.
Pretty good-looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. And this should be a kneel. They just try to kill the clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on their own six.
Let's go! Round 50!
He takes a knee. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, 21-9, FSU. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.